Good afternoon, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. A botched paint job leads to a person getting stabbed and this man facing charges in court. David Kahns went to get his money back when things apparently turned ugly. Ray Brewer was in court when he faced a judge.
2 days after he allegedly slashed a man with a knife over a bad paint job, 38-year-old David Kahns appeared by video in Salem Circuit Court. Police allege that Saturday night, just before 11 p.m., Kahns went to a home at 24 Haverhill Road in Salem to confront Carl Mady. Kahns had hired Mady to paint his house.
The suspect was not happy, allegedly not happy with the work that was performed and in the manner in which it was performed. He was asking for a return on his investment.
According to the affidavit, the victim's girlfriend said Kahns had been sending threatening text messages all day. Kahns then allegedly said he was coming over, and when told it was too late, the children were sleeping, Kahns showed up anyway. The girlfriend says that Kahns entered the house and began punching Mady in the head. The fight then went outside, and Kahns allegedly slashed Mady in the abdomen with a knife before fleeing into some nearby woods. He surrendered when an officer with his weapon drawn ordered Kahns to come out. Kahns is charged with 3 felonies and 1 misdemeanor.
Agreed to a bail of $20,000 cash or corporate surety. Mr. Kahns believes it's likely that he'll be able to use a bail bondsman to post that bail.
Once Kahns posts bail, he will have to stay at least 300 feet away from his alleged victim and his girlfriend and not have any contact with them. He will also have to stay away from the house in Salem. Kahns is due back in court on the 28th for his probable cause hearing. A man is under arrest, caught with heroin in his underwear. Bow police responded to the Hampton Inn for alleged drug activity. Inside, they found this man, James Putnam, who police say admitted to having a hypodermic needle and heroin in his underwear. He's been charged with possession of heroin. 2 other people were also arrested. The man charged in a deadly stabbing at a Manchester club will face a judge in Boston. 26-year-old Joel Martin is charged with second-degree murder in the stabbing death of Darrell Robinson. The Attorney General's office says Robinson was stabbed in the torso at drink early Saturday morning. 2 other people were also stabbed during that fight. Martin faces a fugitive from justice charge. Also in Manchester, the Attorney General's office expected to release the name of a person shot and killed yesterday afternoon on Lake Avenue. So far, no arrests have been made, but police say they have identified everyone involved in the shooting. An autopsy is scheduled for today. An accident in Manchester this morning between 2 school buses. 2 school buses crashed into one another on Beach and Amherst Street this morning. Police say no one was hurt and only 1 bus had minor damage. An exciting addition to the McAuliffe Shepherd Discovery Center up in Concord. Today, crews began installing this satellite built by UNH students back in 1999 to the building's atrium. The satellite never made it to space, but UNH says it launched a lot of careers. The students who built the satellite went on to work for companies like BAE Systems, Raytheon, and NASA as well. Starting tonight at 5, fitting rooms are going high-tech, the new features that let you try more items without having to scour the store. And as the summer travel season heats up, consider all the hard work from travel agents. We'll look at some of the strangest requests they've had to accommodate. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon, everybody.